We're fast approaching the end of 2014. We want to ask you, have you done everything you can to reduce your tax bill this year? Our financial advisor, Elaine Beatles, in studio as she is every week. We want to share some three tax-reducing strategies that have to be done by the end of December. Good to have you here.
Exactly.
So what is the first thing that we should do? What should we do between now and December 31st?
Well, the three things are pre-tax contributions, state tax credits, and deductions. Mm. So the first one I talk about a lot is making that pre-tax contribution to your retirement plan. So if you're an employee and you have access to a 401k or 403b, you can contribute up to $17,500. If you're over 50, you can do another $5,500 to $23,000. Mm-hmm. So what you need to do is right now, go and look at your pay record and see how much you've contributed to those accounts, if any. And you've got your paychecks between now and the end of the year that you can put money into those. And so you'd want to go back and ask your payroll administrator to increase maybe the amount going to your 401k or add money there. Because for every $100 that you're willing to put into that savings, it's your money going into your retirement savings at a 25% marginal tax bracket, you'd save $25. So if it's $1,000, you put in $250. Now, people may come back and say, but that reduces my take-home pay, and it does. So what you need to think about is, do I have a savings account somewhere where I can replace the money that I'm putting into my retirement savings so I can meet my needs?
So that's for somebody who has a job. What about somebody who's self-employed?
Well, you know, self-employed individuals have several options, but the one that will provide the biggest benefit, the largest amount that you can put in pre-tax, is a solo 401k. And the importance about that, it has to be established before December 31st. So you got to sign the paperwork if that's your situation, and then you can fund that between March or January 1st up until April 15th. So mm-hmm. you've got a little more time to figure that out. But the maximum you could put in there if you're over 50 is $57,500. Well, at 25% marginal tax bracket, that's a tax savings of $14,000. So it's worth thinking about how you can do that.
I've got about a minute left. What's your second strategy here?
Indiana 529 plans, you know, college savings plans. Again, you're saving money for a child, a grandchild, yourself, if mm-hmm. you want to go and take college courses, and you get a 20% tax credit that comes right off your tax bill when you file your Indiana tax return for 2014, up to $1,000. So to get the full amount, you'd have to contribute $5,000. But if you only contribute $1,000, you still get $200 back on your taxes.
And a lot of folks are going to wonder about charitable donations.
Right, and that's the third one. Yeah. Charitable deductions must be in the charity's hands, that contribution, by December 31st to get it for this year. And cash is fine to do that, or writing a check, but better would be appreciated securities. So if you've got a mutual fund or shares of individual stock that have grown in value, if you make that a gift by transferring it directly to the charity, you don't have to pay the capital gain tax mm-hmm. that you'd have to pay, plus you get the full amount as a charitable deduction. So
important that we do this before December 31st.
Absolutely.
That's the deadline.
Okay. So start now.
We have more on Beatle Financial on WTHR.com. Elaine, thanks.